Hey everyone, while it might seem a little too early to start talking about sunless tanning and sunscreen, where I live, I am right on time. I'm getting ready actually to go to my son's baseball game this afternoon, and it will be 89 degrees and sunny, and it is the last day of March. So now is as good a time as any to dive into the sunless tanning and sunscreen topic. I'm going to start with how I get tan. Because I have to say, I do not lay out in the sun for a variety of reasons. The first and foremost being it's really stupid. It's kind of like when you see young people smoking. There's no excuse. You know it's bad for you. There are zero benefits to laying out like you're frying yourself like some piece of meat. You're exposed to enough sunlight in your daily life just walking around outside to get your vitamin D. So that's a lame excuse for those of you who still trotting that one out. And I don't want wrinkles and I don't want cancer and I don't want to sit still that long, frankly. So what do I do though to not look so pasty white? Couple of things. If I really want a tan quickly and with as little effort as possible, then I will trot on down to Palm Beach Tan by my house. They almost always have some kind of coupon going on. They have two versions of sunless tanning. They have Versa Spa and they have Mystic Tan. And there are pros and cons to each. The pro with Versa Spa is that I think the color is a little more natural looking. However, it also fades to me a lot quicker than the Mystic Tan. So if you want more bang for your buck, Mimi, leave that. If you want more bang for your buck, I think the Mystic Tan works better. And what I do is right before I go, I like to go either first thing in the morning or last thing before bed. They're open to like 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock at night, probably for this very reason. I'll hop in the shower, get one of those loofah sponge things, and just scrub all my parts, especially my knees, my elbows, right around here. For some reason, I tend to get a lot of dead skin. So I just really want to scrub, not so that I'm peeling off layers of skin, but getting rid of all that stuff. If you're really diligent, there are tons of exfoliating lotion, like body soap stuff, at the drugstore, at Walmart, wherever. Nothing, I don't think it's worth spending a lot of money. Just find something at your local drugstore, grocery store that has exfoliating properties, lather it up on one of those loofahs and go to town. And don't forget your face. This would be a good time to drag out the Clarisonic. Then I just towel dry, no lotion, throw on like a tracksuit, like a juicy hoodie and sweat, something loose or a sundress. If you can forego undergarments, that is a good thing, and you'll see why in a minute. You go and you do your spray thing, and then you don't really want to wear anything that's going to rub or chafe, because that'll wear off the sunless tanner until it sets. So that's why I like kind of loose clothing with no undergarments. Anyway, so I go home, I sleep in it, I like kind of let it saturate my skin, and then the next morning I shower, and the bronzer part will all wash off. It looks kind of scary. And then instead of moisturizing, I will follow up with this. I've recommended this every year. It's the Banana Boat Summer Color. I always get the deep dark color. For some reason, the lighter color comes out more orange on me. This is a more natural color. And so after I shower for the first time, when I shower for the first time after I've tanned with the spray tan, then I will follow up with one application of this, and that makes that tan last a good week and a half. If you think it's starting to fade, just do this again. So that's my speed version and how to maintain my sunless tanner, my spray tan. Now, if I just want to build up a gradual tan, what I've been doing this month, and it's working really well, is I'm using the Nivea Sunkissed Radiant Skin, and again, I got it in the medium to dark shade, and it's hard to tell, but this is day 3, and it's building up a nice, healthy color. There's no streaks. There initially is none of that nasty sunless tanner odor. It does, as the day goes on, you get a faint whiff of it, but it's nothing like Jergens. And to me, I hate the Jergens daily sunless tanner thing. It streaks on me. It stinks. It was a pioneer of its time, but I think that more stuff has come out that is just way better. This is one of them. So I don't use this on my face, but Now, if I don't have time to do the spray tan, I don't have time to run over there or whatever, or I just want to do it at home, then I will use just this, and it's the same steps as if I were going to go spray tanning. I shower with the loofah thing, scrub everywhere, get my face exfoliated, and I use this all over my face. I haven't done this since last summer, but I've never broken out from putting this on my face. I don't know if anybody else has a similar experience, but I do it on my face, I do it on my whole body. You kind of let it sit until it's dry, and then you can get dressed like normal. If I'm at all concerned about how it's gonna go on, I just mix this in equal parts to my face moisturizer and put that on my face. So it's a little, it doesn't come off obviously as dark as the rest of my body, but then the danger of streaking is avoided. And then I always just bronze up my face with bronzer to match the rest of my body. For some other tanning tricks, especially, I've done this on my arms, but really it's just my legs. This is an old bottle. It's the Sally Hansen Airbrush Legs. I mean, I've beaten this up, like literally beaten it. And I don't know why it's so filthy, but I use this in Tan Glow, and it's literally like painting a tan on your body. And if you wait to let it set, it is waterproof. Like, I am not kidding you. Let's just say I've used this to cover some imperfections along my bikini line and went swimming and this stuff stayed put. So, kind of good to have. Another one that if I really want to look tan, I will layer this, is the Lorac Tantalizer, the Body Bronzing Luminizer. Now, this comes in two versions. This is just the body bronzer. There's also one that includes a sunless tanner. I do one of two things. If I want really flawless looking legs, I'll do this first and then put this on top just to kind of make it glow. This also looks good along your décolleté, your arms. There's some shimmer though, so if you don't want to sparkle too much, then you're not going to like this. And then speaking of sparkle, I've mentioned this last summer, but I'm bringing it back out. It's time for it again. It's the Burt's Bees Radiance Body Lotion. And it has natural mica in it. Well, mica is a very reflective, it's like a stone, I guess, or a mineral of some kind. So it's going to sparkle. And I think you can see it's dried up there, but can you see how much the light is reflecting off that little bit? I mean, you could be an extra in a Twilight movie if you overdo it with this. But it's fun at night. I like this at night. Just for the body. Don't put this on your face. Now, to avoid the sun, which is something I do constantly, and I discussed this with my dermatologist on Thursday, so this is confirmed by him. So in the morning, after I wash my face, even in the winter, I always use a moisturizer with sunscreen. Lately, I've been using the CeraVe AM Facial Moisturizing Lotion, and I put a lot on. It has SPF 30, and in the winter, that's it. That's all I do. Now, in the spring, summertime, I will then follow up with, and he said this is fabulous to use, the Neutrogena Ultra Sheer Liquid SPF 55, and even on the back, I think you can see, it says it layers under your makeup, layers invisibly under your makeup. So you just shake it up, and it's starting to dribble out, and you put a few drops, I do more than a few drops, I just smack it on all over, and put it all on, and it acts as a great makeup primer as well. And he said it's great to layer, it's not a problem. The more protection, the better. And then I shake it up again and do some more drops to the back of my hand, because as much as we do to protect our faces, we always forget our hands, and nothing shows your age faster than nasty, veiny, liver-spotted hands. So, some other sunscreens that I use a lot. This is a generic version of the Ultra Sheer Dry Touch, the Neutrogena. This is the CVS version. I like the Dry Touch. I just put some on. I mean, it's not sticky and tacky. So I'll put this on over my moisturizer right before I'm going out. I keep this in my purse. This is the Ocean Potion Cool Touch SPF 50, mostly for the kids if we're going out somewhere so I can get their noses and their cheeks. My Blistex is an SPF 15. There's tons of lip balms that has FPF in it. Don't forget about your lips. That's skin too. Something that came out last year that I think it was last year that we ended up using quite a bit, is the wet skin kids. Because you know how when your kids are swimming, you put sunscreen on them, then they go in the water, then they come out, they need to reapply, and you don't want to have to towel them dry. So this goes on to wet skin. So it's a little pricey, but the convenience factor, I think, is worth it. And that's $70. And then I tend to go for the generics if I can. So Walgreens have the sheer body mist sunscreen in $70. I use this on me. And then the other sunscreen, excuse me, that I do use a lot when I'm out at the pool or something with my kids is the I love the Ocean Potion range. This is the anti-aging sunblock in SPF 30. And I like it because it smells really good. I mean, it just, I don't know how to describe it. It's just tropical and sunny, and it's just a nice scent. And it happens to be water and sweat resistant, so I like those. The last thing that I do in the summer, especially when I'm, not if I'm just out and about walking around, but like this afternoon where I'll be sitting in the sun, is my hat. This is my latest one. I got this one at Target, $14.99. I don't really like this thing on top. I may get rid of that later, but this is like walking around with your own little umbrella, and you can play with the brim. And anyway, you can tie a scarf around it, you could dress it up, whatever you want to do, but it gets my shoulders, the back of my neck, shades my face some more. I look a little fashionable. I look a little crazy, actually. I know people are going to think I'm nuts, but I like it. And because it's straw, that there's still air circulation, so your head doesn't get sweaty. Anyway, so those are my tips on what I do to get tan, to appear tan, and to avoid the real sun. And anyway, I hope some of these work out for you. I hope it's sunny wherever you are or coming to you soon. And thanks so much for watching. Have an awesome day. Bye-bye.